Hello, welcome to EPG Parthshala. Myself Dr. Mamta, Assistant Professor from Galgodia's University. In this module, various methods will be discussed for the extraction of various poisons or drugs depending on their classes or categories. These extraction procedures depend on the phytochemical properties of poisons. There are various traditional as well as modern methods employed for the extraction of poison from biological material. The factors which affect the selection of methods extraction depends on the type of poison and the available biological matrix that constitutes poison. There are various types of poisons which have already been discussed in the earlier module, such as non-volatile organic poison, volatile organic poisons, metallic poisons, anions, vegetable poisons, etc. So, depending on the type of poison to be extracted from the given matrix, there are specific extraction procedures for the specific class of compound that I will be discussing one by one. First category is a non-volatile organic poisons. Non-volatile organic poisons include drugs such as acidic, basic, neutral and plant poisons, especially alkaloids, glycosides, etc., along with the pesticides. In this method, ammonium sulfate method is used for the screening of non-volatile drugs such as barbiturates, alkaloids, tranquilizers, etc. And the procedure involved is as about 50 to 100 grams of a visceral tissues are cut into small pieces, macerated and mixed with the 100 ml of 5% acetic acid in a beaker. To make a saturated solution, solid ammonium sulfate is added it with the frequent shaking. About 20 grams of a solid ammonium chloride is added to it. Then it is heated on a boiling water bath for 3 hours. In suspected case of acetone poisoning, temperature should not exceed 60 degrees centigrade. The mixture is then cooled and filtered. The residue on the funnel is then extracted with the two portion of 100 ml of 5% acetic acid and filtered as earlier. Then both the above filtrate are pooled in a 500 ml of a separating funnel, and the residual slurry on the filter paper is washed with the 100 ml diethyl ether and collected in another container. The ether fraction so obtained is added to the aqueous acidic extract in a separating funnel and shaken vigorously for 5 minutes and then separated. 100 ml of ether is again added to the acidic layer, shaken vigorously for 5 minutes and separated, and then again separated. The above ether layer are combined, and then acidic ether extract is tested for aspirin, barbiturates, salicylic acid, benzodiazepines, lysergides, etc. The aqueous solution remaining in the separating funnel after separation of acidic drug is made alkaline by addition of ammonium hydroxide, and it is extracted thrice with the 100 ml of portion of chloroform ether in 1:3 ratio. The aqueous layer is retained for the extraction of opium alkaloid. To better understand these extraction procedures, one should also know about the type of poisons and basic nature, that is what types of toxicity is possessed by that compound. So from this method we can extract alkaloids of opium. So what is opium? Opium is a dried juice obtained by incision of unripe capsule of a poppy plant. Its botanical name is Papaver somniferum, and it belongs to Papaveraceae family. It constitutes two types of alkaloids based on their structure, that is phenanthrene and isoquinoline group of alkaloids. And alkaloids of opium are known as opiates. These are also known as narcotics. The phenanthrene group comprises morphine, codeine, thebaine, and their synthetic derivatives are dionine, heroin, etc. And they have narcotics properties, while isoquinoline group comprises papaverine and narcotine, which have mild analgesic but not narcotic properties. These opiates act on the central nerve system, first stimulate the central nerve system and later a depression followed by necrosis. Among the other alkaloids, morphine is the major naturally occurring alkaloid of opium and known for its main psychotropic action. In clinical medicines, morphine is regarded as the gold standard in management of severe pain. It acts directly on the central nerve system to relieve the pain, while heroin is a semi-synthetic alkaloid, and it is interesting to note that heroin has twice the potency as that of a morphine. This urine can be taken orally, can be inhaled or can be had by injecting itself into the vein through an injection. It is a potent analgesic with a strong euphoric effects. It also known by other name as smack, brown sugar, junk or dope. It can also smoked, inhaled as snuff or injected. Among all the addictive drugs, it is the most dangerous drug. So forensically it is very important to examine the presence of such alkaloids. Now the organic layers so obtained in ammonium sulfate methods after separations are combined and washed with the 50 ml of a distilled water. It is extracted thrice with the 25 ml of a 10% sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid fraction are combined and taken into another separating funnel and organic layer is discarded. To it, 50 ml mixture of chloroform ether in 1:3 ratios is added. To make the solution alkaline, diluted ammonium hydroxide solution is added to it and shaken for 5 minutes. The organic layer so obtained is separated. The extraction is repeated thrice with the chloroform ether in 1:3 ratios. The organic layer after separation are combined, washed with 150 ml of water, dried by passing through the anhydrous sodium sulfate and evaporated to dryness. Then this fraction of extract is tested for aconite, dhatura, opium alkaloids, amphetamines, methaqualone, etc. Now the acid ether extract obtained from ammonium sulfate method may be further separated into three different fractions. For the first fraction, the acid ether layer is shaken with the 25 ml of a 5% sodium bicarbonate solution. The aqueous layer is removed and taken into another separating funnel and then acidified with the diluted sulfuric acid and again extracted with the 25 ml of a ether. This ether fraction is passed through hydrous sodium sulfate and dried, and this residual fraction contains salicylates. Now for the second fraction, the ether layer, that is the acid ether fraction after washing with the sodium bicarbonate, is extracted twice with the 25 ml portion of normal sodium hydroxide solution. The aqueous layer are separated from ether layer, combined and taken into another separating funnel and made acidic by adding dilute sulfuric acid and extracted twice with the 25 ml of a ether. Then this ether fraction is washed with the 25 ml of a distilled water and then dried by adding anhydrous sodium sulfate and evaporated to dryness. The residual fractions contains purified form of barbiturates. Chemically, barbiturates are the derivatives of barbituric acid. These are used as a sedatives, hypnotics, anesthetic and anxiolytic. Accidental poisoning by barbiturate is a common in a person using barbiturates as a medicines. Now for the third fraction, the ether layer is washed with the water after extracting with the sodium hydroxide solution and then evaporated to dryness, and this residual fraction contains carbamates and other neutral drugs. Now the another method of extraction is Stas Otto method, which is used for the extraction of alkaloids from vegetable matrix or visceral tissues. In this method, 50 grams of a biological material is macerated with the sufficient quantity of spirit, and quantity of spirit taken is about 2 to 3 times the weight of biological materials, and acidified with the tartaric acid in a flask. This mixture is then heated on a steam bath for 1 to 2 hours with the frequent shaking at a fixed intervals. The extraction is carried out for about 24 hours with the steam off. Filtration is then carried out using filter paper. The filtrate obtained is evaporated and then residue is again extracted with the acidified alcohol and then filtered and washed with the hot rectified spirit. The filtrates are combined and evaporated in a porcelain basin on the steam bath to a syrupy mass. To this, about 100 ml of a rectified spirit is added slowly with the constant stirring. If the alcohol is added repeatedly, the insoluble matter will become sticky and resulted into the loss of alkaloids. It is warmed with the stirring or about half an hour and then filtered. This process is repeated again for one more time and alcoholic extract are combined and evaporated to dryness. The residue is dissolved in about 50 ml of water acidified with the diluted sulfuric acid and filtered after about an hour. The poisons are thus come in the aqueous layer, are transferred to a separating funnel and extracted with the about 25 ml of ether, chloroform, etc. Acid solution contains coloring matters, toxic oils, resins, salicylic acids and its derivatives such as aspirin, cellul, etc. Barbiturates, sulfenol, narcotics, narcotine and alkaloids of ergots, certain glycosides such as thevetin which has escaped in initial treatment for purification. The acidic aqueous solution is then made alkaline by adding sodium carbonate or ammonia solution to separate the free base from its salt. The alkaline solution is then extracted with the 25 ml chloroform. In the same way, it will constitute all the alkaloids except morphine. Only traces of morphine are extracted, and those feebly basic compounds which are partially extracted in the acidic layer. The extraction is repeated 2 to 3 times in the suspected case of morphine poisoning. It can be extracted at this stage by adding amyl alcohol or mixture of chloroform ether in 3:1 ratio or chloroform alcohol mixture in 9:1 ratio. The chloroform or amyl alcohol fraction are combined, evaporated to dryness, and now it is ready for further purification and analysis. It is purified by dissolving it in about 20 ml of water acidified with the sulfuric acid and then filtered. This filtrate is again extracted with the chloroform, first in acid and then alkaline medium as earlier. These extracts are evaporated to dryness for the analysis purpose. Now, the modified Stas-Otto method. Modification in Stas-Otto method has been carried out to minimize the chances of loss of poison at each step, as Stas-Otto method involves so many steps which may also result in a complete loss of poison. Therefore, the method has been modified with the minimum following steps. Extraction of biological material is carried out with the absolute alcohol or to prevent the hydrolysis at room temperature. Temperature should not exceed 40 degree centigrade in suspected case of aconite, belladonna, datura or cocaine poisoning. The fraction so obtained is evaporated under reduced pressure and following points are taken into consideration while extraction. The extraction with the rectified spirit is carried out for 48 hours if biological material is preserved in a saturated saline solution. As the stomach contained too much fluid, the extraction should be done with the absolute alcohol for 3 to 4 times. In case of extraction of stomach wash, add absolute alcohol just to 2 times the quantity of a stomach wash, acidified with the tartaric acid and allowed to evaporate in a steam bath. For filtration, Buchner funnel is preferred. Agitation is carried out to prevent the loss due to emulsion formation, and it is carried out 2 to 3 times in the beginning and not exceeding 12 times at the end without ordinary solvents such as ether or chloroform or amyl alcohol. In case of formation of emulsion, it is evaporated on a steam bath and then residue is taken in fresh solvent. On the other hand, various procedures are employed for the extraction of pesticides depending on the matrices. Pesticides are the compounds of non-volatile organic poisons and are used to kill insects, bugs, rodents, etc. Many pesticides can cause poisoning after being swallowed, inhaled or absorbed through the skin. Some insecticides are odorless, thus the person is unaware of being exposed to them. Most of the insecticides make certain nerves fire erratically, causing many organs to become overactive and eventually to stop functioning. As those are easily available and cheap, these are used for suicidal purposes despite its unpleasant taste and painful death. These compounds are also used for homicidal purposes by mixing it with the alcohol, especially with the toddy, which masks its smell. It may also be mixed with the another foods. Accidental poisoning is also occur due to contamination and leakage. And the extraction of pesticides in a biological material with viscera, stomach content, gastric lavage and blood is difficult due to the inference of fat, regarded protein and degraded protein and coloring matter in the matrices. The extract requires proper cleanup except micellar method. This method are based on solvent extraction cum stripping under diverse conditions with nature and condition of matrices, use of organic solvents, etc. In first method, biological material such as viscera, stomach content or gastric lavage etc. are macerated into fine slurry by mixing with the equal amount of anhydrous sodium sulfate and transferred into a conical flask with an air condenser. 50 ml of anhexane is added to the flask and heated on a hot water bath for 1 hour. The content are cooled and filtered. The residual slurry is extracted twice with the 25 ml of portion of normal hexane. The filtered anhexane fraction are combined and taken into a separating funnel. This hexane layer is vigorously shaken with the 15 ml, 10 ml and again 10 ml portion of acetonitrile, which are previously saturated with the normal hexane. The acetonitrile layers are mixed and taken into another clean separating funnel and diluted 10 times with the distilled water. 25 ml of a saturated sodium sulfide solution is added to it and extracted thrice with the 25 ml portion of anhexane. The anhexane layer are combined, concentrated to 5 ml by evaporating on water bath and 5 gram of anhydrous sodium sulfate is added. The extract is evaporated and when required for analysis. In second method, 50 grams of macerated tissues or biological materials are mixed with the equal amount of anhydrous sodium sulfate and 100 ml of acetone in a conical flask and then refluxed on a hot water bath for 1 hour. After cooling, the acetone extract is filtered. The residue is extracted twice with the further 50 ml portion of acetone. The acetone fraction are combined and concentrated by evaporation up to 50 ml for further processing means for cleanup. The above acetone extract approximately 50 ml is taken into a separating funnel and diluted with the 150 ml of water. Add 20 ml of a saturated solution of sodium sulfate to the same. The content are extracted thrice with the 25 ml portion of chloroform with the gentle shaking. The chloroform extracts are combined, washed with the water acetone mixture in 1:1 ratio and finally with the 50 ml of water. The washed chloroform layer is passed through anhydrous sodium sulfate and then evaporated to dryness by passing air. The another method employed is for the extraction of pesticides from stomach wash, urine and vomit content. In this method, the sample approximately 20 ml of stomach wash or urine or 10 to 20 grams of vomit is taken into conical flask. Then 50 ml of anhexane is added. It is refluxed on a water bath for half an hour. After cooling, the liquid is filtered, mixed with the 20 ml of anhexane and taken in a separating funnel. The anhexane layer is separated, passed through anhydrous sodium sulfate and evaporated to dryness by passing a current of dry air through it. And for the extraction of pesticides from blood, different methods is employed. In this method, 20 ml of blood is mixed with the 10 ml of 10% sodium tungstate solution and 15 ml of 1 normal sulfuric acid, shaken for 2 minutes and then filtered. The filtrate is kept reserved. The residue is washed with the 215 ml portions of 0.1 normal sulfuric acid. The washings are collected and mixed with the filtrate, transferred into a separating funnel and extracted thrice with the 20 ml portion of anhexane. The anhexane layers are combined, passed through anhydrous sodium sulfate and the solvent is removed by passing a stream of air stated in the previous method. Now, the last method is for the extraction of pesticides in a non-biological material, that is from vegetable grains or another edible commodities. In this procedure, 20 to 25 grams of rice or more if available, 100 ml of drinking water or tea or coffee or milk, 20 to 25 grams of soil, sand, grains or cereals are taken and to these material, direct solvent extraction is carried out with the 50 to 100 ml of diethyl ether without adding ammonium sulfate. The ethereal extract is concentrated to 20 ml and cleaned up by column chromatography. The ethereal extract is collected, evaporated to dryness by passing stream of air and tested for pesticides. Now, how to extract volatile organic poison from biological matrix? The method is applicable for volatile organic or inorganic poisons under different conditions of pH, that is acidic and alkaline. First method for the extraction of volatile organic poisons is acid stream distillation. In this method, 50 to 100 grams of viscera, stomach content, vomit or other material are to be taken separately. They should be homogenized by adding 3 to 5 times distilled water and acidified with the tartaric acid or sulfuric acid and subjected to the steam distillation. The condenser and receiving flask should be well cooled with the ice, especially during the hot season. The outlet of the condenser being dipped in little water or sodium hydroxide solution or any other reagent as necessary. It is better to collect the distillate in 4 to 5 fractions, of which first one should not exceed 20 ml and the remaining fraction should be 50 ml. Each flask containing the material should preferably be heated on the water bath. The distillate, as stated above, contains alcohol, pyraldehyde, other aldehydes, acetone, carbolic acid and phenolic derivatives, carbon disulfide, thymol, camphor, turpentine, nitroglycerine, benzene, other volatile acids, etc. For cyanides and carbolic acid, the distillate is collected in a 10 ml of 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide solution. Now, the second method for the extraction of volatile organic poison is alkaline steam distillation. After the completion of acid distillation, the flask is allowed to cool and its contents are rendered alkaline by adding sodium hydroxide solution. The alkaline mixture is then distilled again in the same way as before and the distillate collected in two fractions, the first fraction of about 20 ml and the second fraction of about 50 ml. The distillate from the alkaline mixture may contain aniline, pyridine, nicotine, conine, ammonia and volatile bases. There is another class of toxic substances, that is cations, such as metals. For examples, for the extraction of metals, two methods are used, namely dry ash method and second is wet digestion method. In dry ash method, 10 to 50 gram of the biological material is taken into silica crucible and heated in a Bunsen burner to remove the moisture content to partially destroy the organic material. The crucible is then kept in a Muffel furnace and the temperature is raised up to 550 degree centigrade to perform incineration of the organic matter for 1 hour. After incineration, the crucible is taken out. The color of the residue is noted at this stage. When it is hot, in the presence of zinc, residue shows yellow color, while in the presence of copper, residue shows bluish color. The residue is then boiled with the 10 ml of 4 normal hydrochloric acid in a silica basin and then it is filtered. The clear acidic solution so obtained is tested for the presence of metallic poisons such as arsenic, mercury, lead, copper, bismuth, zinc, barium, etc. by group analysis or using micro methods, chromatographic techniques, etc. Another method which is used for metallic poison is a wet digestion method. In wet digestion method, 50 grams of visceral tissues or 10 ml of blood is taken into a Geldal flask and 20 to 40 ml of concentrated nitric acid is added to it and heated with the care in a small flame when the mass begins to liquefy. The heating is continued till liquefaction of material is not completed and is carried out in the presence of brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide in the flask. At this stage, about 20 to 30 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid is added and the flask is heated over a wire gauze and concentrated nitric acid is also added drop wise using dropping funnel at the rate of about 10 drops per minute so that it result in the continuous production of brown fumes in the flask. Heating is continued until all the organic matter is destroyed and at this stage liquid becomes clear and colorless or straw colored. To find out whether oxidation is completed or not, flask is heated without adding any nitric acid. If there is any unburned organic content left, the liquid begins to darken. If the digestion is completed, no darkening takes place. In the earlier case, when the organic matter is not completely oxidized, addition of nitric acid and heating should be continued. To expel the nitric acid completely, heating is continued for 15 minutes more. After cooling, 25 ml of saturated ammonium oxalate solution is added and is boiled until sulfate trioxide fumes appear. This confirms complete removal of nitric acid. It is then cooled, diluted with an equal quantity of water and carefully transferred into a beaker. The beaker is heated on a hot plate or sand bath to expel the excess sulfuric acid. The solution is then cooled and diluted with the distilled water. in a such a manner that the strength of acid is remained about 10%. Precipitate may form which contains salts of lead, bismuth, tin, barium, strontium or silver, etc. The precipitate is filtered and tested for these metals by group analysis, and quantitative analysis is required if required. The next category of poison is anions, which includes halides, azides, etc. For the isolation of toxic anions, dialysis method is used. In this method, 10 grams of tissues is chopped into small pieces and placed in a cellophane membrane bag. The bag is slowly rotated in a beaker containing 100 ml of distilled water, employing an electrical motor. The separation of particles in a liquid carried out on the basis of their ability to pass through this membrane. After 1 hour, water of beaker is taken out and replaced by fresh water, and bag is rotated for another half an hour. This water is then taken out, pooled with the previous fraction, and evaporated to a small fraction using water bath. If required, it is filtered and tested for the presence of toxic anions such as halides, azides, etc., such as chlorides, bromides, which may include zinc chloride, ferrous chloride, phosphate, sulfate, nitrate, nitrite, etc. Now, total alcoholic extraction method. The total alcoholic extraction procedure is employed for the extraction of mainly indigenous poisonous drugs such as croton, castor, marking nut, oleander, calotropis, etc. In this method, 10 gram of the tissue is chopped into small pieces, or biological material is taken in an evaporation dish to remove moisture completely on a hot water bath. It is then macerated with the rectified spirit with the twice the quantity of biological material and transferred to an Erlenmeyer flask. 2.85 ml of acetic acid is added and filtered with a reflux condenser. It is then refluxed on boiling water bath for 4 hours, cooled and then filtered. The filtrate is evaporated to dryness. This total alcoholic extract is evaluated for the presence of mainly indigenous poisonous drugs such as croton, castor, bilawan, kaner, madar, mushrooms, etc. So in this module, you would have learned different extraction techniques for different poisons depending on their chemical nature and the matrix to which they bound. Thank you.